Hey everybody, I'm Brendan72Mo. This is the Vapid Minivan Custom, and I'm about to find out if it'll off-road in the snow. Of course, you can vote for the vehicles that you want to see in the regular Will It Off-Road series by clicking in the link in the description down below. You can vote for any of the vehicles that I currently own. I'm updating the list every time I get a new car. So every time there's new DLC, the list grows. And every time there's not DLC, the list grows. I think I'm up to 187 cars now in GTA Online. But for the Will It Off-Road in the snow, of course, there's no way I can do voting because the snow's gone. I did, however, ask for feedback and suggestions for vehicles that you guys would want to see going up and down Mount Chiliad in the snow when I first announced that I'd be doing this offshoot. And so a lot of the vehicles that you've already seen and those that you're going to see over the coming weeks in this offshoot are based directly on your feedback. So fun times. So the minivan custom. All-wheel drive. A decent power for what it is. I mean, it's a minivan. You can't really expect it to be the fastest vehicle in the game. But it does okay. It'll get some serious straight line speed if you've got the room for it. But that's not really what we're into for Will It Off-Road. It's all about traction and control. The all-wheel drive system does help a little bit, though, as you've already seen, isn't guaranteed to keep it from sliding around. One of the things that will happen a couple times and just happened right there is if the front wheels start spinning with the back wheels, then I lose my ability to steer, and that's just the way physics work. If there's no traction, or in this case, no friction, with the surface you're driving on, the wheels are just going to spin, and they're also not going to have that friction to be able to gain traction to turn the vehicle. So you deal with it. So you're probably wondering, why in the world I have a minivan? You've seen a lot of my cars. If you've watched my garage tour series, you've seen a lot of my cars, the live streams, and you've seen them in this Will It Off-Road series. You know, I usually go for pretty tasteful designs. Though I do have a few oddballs here and there. The minivan actually started as a joke back on Xbox 360. When I first started live streaming, I wanted to kind of see what other live streamers were doing just to get some ideas of what I thought would work for my own particular channel, what I did and didn't like about what other live streamers were doing, and, you know, kind of grow on that. And one thing I noticed is that a lot of people who were live streaming and uploading videos of GTA, well, there was a running theme, let me put it that way. They would take whatever vehicle they thought was the it vehicle to have, and almost without exception, paint it chrome, put the crew color on as the pearl color, and then they throw dollar sign wheels on the damn thing. And I saw that time and time and time again. And so I thought, okay, fine. Let's get a good car to make fun of that with. What's probably the least likely vehicle that people will be like, hey man, cool ride. And I thought about it for a few days, driving around in GTA, just kind of looking to see what spawns. And I came up with the minivan. So I grabbed one, stole it, painted the thing chrome, put the crew color on as a pearl paint and slap some dollar sign wheels on it. And of course then now on new gen here on PC, we have the option to upgrade to the minivan customs, and it's actually not a bad looking van now. Aside from those dollar sign wheels and a garish horn, it's pretty tasteful to look at. But it's also doing really well in the snow getting to the top of the mountain. I'm pretty sure that I've tested this in the regular Will It Off-Road series and it did really well then as well. This is going to be a bit of a challenge because it does ride really low. Trying to control the wheel spin, but still have enough power to get up the hill. And it's doing it. It's slow, but it's making it. There we go. The minivan custom is up in 3 minutes, 54 seconds. So Will It Off-Road in the snow? Yeah, surprisingly well. The question will be is how will it do on the controlled descent? That is going to be a bit of a bigger problem, I think. Mainly because the brakes on the minivan custom aren't the best. They do one of two things. They either lock up, and of course they're gonna lock up right there, but they either lock up, even on dry pavement, or they just aren't strong enough. And it seems to be really hit or miss with this van. It's really weird. So if they lock up, that could send it spinning. And if they don't do their job, that could have too much speed and send me sliding over the edge. You can probably already see there a little bit that the back end is, every time I get on the brakes while we're going downhill, the back end wants to come around on me. It's kind of a bit of a challenge, but it's not too bad as long as I keep the speed down. We should be okay. Coming around our first big bend here as we head down, and things look pretty good. Another big bend, and the back end came around on me a little bit there. Maybe a little too much speed. I apologize for the breaks in my voiceover. I got my video card back the day that I'm doing this voiceover. Of course, I recorded these vehicles weeks ago. But I got my video card back the day that I'm recording this. And I started a new job in just like 2 days. And so I've been in a rush today, trying to get a bunch of videos recorded as the minivan's brakes locked up and sent me spinning around. Thankfully, there was a big rock there to stop me from going over the edge. But I've been recording just a ton of videos today that I can then edit tomorrow and then throughout the week after I get home from work. Recording is always the more time-consuming part of it because I can just edit them and let them render while I sleep and then just upload them when they need to be uploaded. So my voice is about shot today. So I apologize if I just suddenly stopped talking. It's because I'm probably having a coughing fit or my voice gave out. And I'll edit those bits out. But it will cause some quiet bits in my voiceover. The minivan kind of bumps and jumps its way over these bigger jumps. It's a little front heavy. It's a bit difficult to get this thing back flat. Of course, well, now it did all right. And it came around that corner quite nicely. We've seen some vehicles that do really well coming down the hill, and then they lose it right there at the end. But the minivan's doing okay. Wish we could say the same for the next vehicle, which is another custom. Of course, you already know what it is. You saw the thumbnail and you read the title. But, yeah, the next vehicle, well, let's just say it doesn't do as well as the minivan. We'll leave it there. Bottomed out a little bit coming around that corner. It's just because of the low ride height on this. It's slammed down to the ground, and I figured on all the custom vehicles, I'm always going to try them in their low rider stance first. And then if they have problems, I can always raise them up. Oh, brakes locked up on me a little bit, but I got it back under control. Able to get around that corner there. Back end's wanting to come out every time I get on the gas, even just a little bit. It's getting real wiggly on me, but we are down in 3 minutes. 39, almost 40 seconds, which means taking it back to the top of Mount Chiliad and driving it off the side to see what type of damage it can take. Didn't get the most speed coming off of there, and oh, already a big collision. Such a hard collision, it even took some of my character's health. I'm pretty sure I'm on my second character. Oh, and again. Yeah, this is my second character, Brenton. Wow, that's surprising. This thing has 100% armor, but those were both really big crashes. You would think I'd be doing it again here, but it's not. We've already lost quite a few of the windows. And it looks like, yep, there goes the back door. Kind of figured that would come off pretty quick because it was coming open already. At this point, I'm just trying to get the thing back under control to stop flipping around. So far, I've not really been on the throttle much. This has just been gravity pulling me down the hill. There we go. Got it spun back around. Hopefully now we can keep going down. And never mind. In a straight line as I ricochet off a bunch more rocks. It's kind of like being a pinball. The snow makes the damage descent a lot more fun, I guess is the word. It is entertaining to watch. But, you know, normally I could get a little bit of control if I could get the wheels on the ground at all. But the snow, well, no such luck. But it's okay, because that's why we do the damage to say, is to see the things tumble to a potential demise. And we lost a few vehicles. Only two or three have blown up due to the damage to say. Two or three more have blown up because I blew them up. Because I hate them. Oh! Slammed into that wall really hard there. It's doing all right to this bumpy muddy bit, though. I'm really surprised. Coming up over the wood pile, or around the wood pile. We are down in a minute 46 seconds. Let's take a look at our damage. We've got all the lights busted out. Most of the windows are gone. The front bumper's gone. The rear door is, said sayonara. There is pretty significant body denting, and we have some bent wheels. So the minivan took a pretty good beating coming down the side of Mount Chili. Yeah, but that brings us to our next vehicle. The Sabre Turbo Custom. If you've driven a muscle car in the snow, you know that for the most part, it's all about wheel spin and donuts and entertaining slides. Maybe not when you really were expecting or wanting them to happen. And well, yeah, this is a really high-powered muscle car. As you can see by the current timestamp, we're only about 11 and a half minutes into a 31, almost 32-minute long video. And that should give you some indication about how this is going to go. Already have to be really gentle on the throttle on these turns, because every time I even blip just a little bit extra, that back end starts to get away, and I have to let off the throttle and get it back in line. I am, once again, though, leaving the Sabre Turbo in its slammed configuration. I didn't really go for a lowrider look that much on this vehicle. I wanted to keep the muscle car look. I love the Sabre Turbo as stock vehicle, and I love it as the Sabre Turbo Custom. I think it's one of the best-looking cars in the game. But again, I have a soft spot for old muscle cars. Here comes our first really big challenge. A lot of vehicles have struggled with this bit. A lot of wheel spin, but we're up right over it, so not too bad. Of course, now we'll see if I can keep enough speed up on this really long incline, or if the wheels are spinning. And there's not a lot I can do about that. You're probably thinking, Brandon, just let off the gas. Well, I have been letting off the gas. You can hear it in the engine noise. I am constantly adjusting where I am on the throttle to try to get that wheel spin under control. But every time they spin, it just suddenly starts bouncing off the rev limiter. But it made its way up slowly for that bit of a challenge. This should be a little bit easier, but we're now coming to our next big one where a lot of vehicles struggle. This is going to be where we spend a lot of time. It's just I couldn't get the speed to get up through there because I couldn't get enough traction to pile on some speed. And because of that, when it slowed down and I tried to keep going forward, the wheels just started spinning. Doing my best to just gently throttle, trying to use the handbrake to keep me from sliding backwards. But I'm not in the best position here. Excuse me as I hiccup. Not in the best position here. And neither was Commander, apparently. Bye, Commander! He goes sliding down the hill. But he's in a nice off-road truck. If you're wondering why I was just sitting there, it's because I was trying to assess the situation, decided it would be best to back up and try to take another stab at it. Maybe see if I can't get some speed here. Because I think if I can get some speed, that'll carry me up and over through here. I just don't know that I'm going to be able to get that speed up. Because a lot of wheel spin already, and then... Yeah, see, I'm just struggling to get any type of speed, and then instantly the wheels start spinning. Thought maybe on some of the cars you can just really full throttle them and push through the wheel spin. Not so much with the Sabre Turbo, at least not on that run. So I'm going to very carefully back up once again. Poor Commander, I keep backing up, and he's trying to get up the mountain as well. I love it when these guys escort me up the mountain, though. It makes it a lot of fun to kind of see how some other people are handling it. So, just trying to figure out my best line of attack here. Gonna give it another go. Normally, freewheeling on off-road, a vehicle gets three shots at any one section that it struggles at, but since we're in the snow, I'm willing to give him a little bit of extra time before I call it a nope. So that's what I'm doing here. Looks like Rocket is making his way up the hill as well. I think he's on a bicycle during this one. Yeah, I think it's a bike that he found. He discovered a glitch on the bike that was letting him, like, basically levitate on a bike. It was really cool. So I raised it up this time to see if maybe I could keep the bottom from dragging and slowing me down, and managed to then hit the rocks. So, not so good there. Almost hit Commander. Yep, there's Rocket on his bicycle. You'll probably see him hop up in the air a few times. It's not lag. It's just, it's a weird glitch that this bike was doing. I don't know if it does it all the time. But it basically looks like E.T. has taken over the bike and he's trying to fly towards the moon. He was just messing around with it for hours. I think he stayed on that bike for 3 or 4 hours that night. He's trying again, trying to keep wheel spin down. Got it raised up to get over the rocks, but that also, when you have it raised up, you lose traction. So I've lowered it back down, trying to get some grip. Trying to just push this thing. It is inching forward, but then gravity takes over and I just cannot keep enough of that wheel spin translated into any type of traction, and we're going more backwards than forwards. You can hear I'm being really gentle on the throttle. Oh, it's starting to inch forward again, but nope, the wheels lost it, bounced off the rev limiter. This thing could really do with a locked diff, because that left rear wheel's spinning while the right rear wheel has grip, and I think that's part of my problem. Of course, there goes the right rear wheel now. Trying to keep from sliding all the way back down. Most vehicles are to the top of the mountain by now, but we're not even halfway up yet. Just trying to assess what I need to do here to keep from sliding backwards to see if there's any way, and that camera angle just gives you a good sense of how steep it really is right here. It doesn't look like it when you're just driving it, but this is a very steep part of the mountain, which is why we're struggling in the snow in a muscle car. Yep, that little drop-off's getting strangely close, or uncomfortably close. There's Rocket levitating in the air again. And for some reason, the hydraulics on the Sabre Turbo just started doing a weird glitchy thing, making the car rock around like that. I'm not sure what that was all about. I know it looked like I was maybe rocking the stick, trying to get it to do it. Nah. It was just the car. Excuse me as I hiccup again mid-sentence. Oh yeah, I don't know what's causing it to shimmy around like that. It's really weird. Alright, let's see if we can't get a run off of here. Right now, I'm kind of hung up where the rocks come out of the side. Every time I try to go forward, it drags on them. And if I raise it up to get over him, well, then I don't have as much traction. But I am dangerously close to going back and over that edge. So if I do wind up going over the edge, I'm going to have to try to control it. I'm trying to take another stab, get going, and it just cannot get over that ledge. Instead, it just wants to sit there and do the shimmy shake. Because who knows why. Rockstar logic. And there we go, back over the edge. I was able to save it, though. So, At this point, Commander rammed into my car. At this point, I decided I was just going to go for it one more time. Because I'm convinced that since it made it up those first two challenges, that it can do it. I know that it has to be possible. There has to be a way. So I'm just going to floor it and nope, screwed myself over. And so back down, being careful not to go over the edge. Believe it or not, at that point, it was better to stay on the gas and keep the back wheels spinning, because it helped me basically. You probably heard the term steer with the throttle, and that's exactly what I was doing. So I'm going to raise it up, gun it again, and hopefully this time will be the charm. And it looks like, yep, lowered it back down so I get traction now. Come on, baby. I know you can do it. I'm just going to keep pushing, trying to find that place where I can get some traction. Definitely moving forward now, and there we go. That is why I did not give up. I knew it could do it. I knew it had it in it. Definitely not enjoyable, very stressful, not fun at all, but it did it. And for you, it was either really entertaining or really boring to watch me struggle to get this thing up the hill. And now I know that I can just do wheel spin to these parts because I'm not going to slide back down because it's not as steep. And even if I did start sliding, I could just let off the gas and then get going again. We have another steep section coming up. Let's see how we do here. Just going to power through it. Because that seems to be the best thing in this car, is just to kind of power through it. Keep moving forward. As long as it doesn't get too steep, it doesn't seem to matter that the wheels are spinning. Granted, you know, most of the energy from the engine's being wasted on wheel spin, but it does manage to move it forward some. Because that's not how it works in real life, but whatever. It's a video game. I mean, I just noticed it's really hard to see the car because it's so dark. I try to avoid recording at night, mainly because it makes for really terrible thumbnails and it makes it really hard to see the vehicles. But since I was limited for time with just a few days of snow, I definitely made exceptions to my nighttime recording rule. But it's doing all right now. Definitely making some progress here. Trying to keep just the wheel spin down, so I just want to try to keep traction. Because it's a lot easier when it actually has traction. But there we go, it let loose again. Man, this is taking forever. When's the last time we had a vehicle take this long to get to the top? The hearse? No, even the hearse, but granted that was Romero hearse. It was in the dry. I think it was 7.5 minutes to get to the top of the mountain. I don't remember how long the brigade took, but I don't think it was this long. So now the question is, how will it do on the back of these rocks where it's already, even in the dry, really limited traction? So just a slippery surface. And it's got that low ride height, your ground clearance, or however you want to say it. So I'm going to back up so I can hopefully get some speed if I can keep the back wheels biting. And I'm just going to charge this thing here. See if I can't get up. And, oh, the back end let loose and it started sliding. Come on, baby. Oh, so close. Going to give it another shot, though. I think since it's made it this far, as it tries to spin around on me, I think since it's made it this far, it deserves a chance, don't you? I do. Definitely do. And that's why I'm doing it. So back down a little bit here. This commander stands behind me for moral support. All right, let's try again. Raise it up this time so hopefully I don't get hung up on those rocks. Let's see if this will have enough grip in the raised up position. I don't know, this always compromises the traction, but it's doing it. I think we're gonna get there this time. Oh, it's sliding, but yeah, there we go. We are up in 12 minutes and 2 seconds. Will the Sabre Turbo off-road in the snow? Yeah, barely. I don't recommend it at all. Not at all. It was not fun. But that means now it's time for the controlled descent. Which, who knows how this is going to go. I mean, if I keep the speed down, in theory, it should be okay. Raising it up to get over these rocks here, just so I don't drag and get stuck down on the side. Just going really slow, being very gentle, just so I don't go sliding off the side of the hill. And there we go. That was pretty, that was nice. Yeah, that worked out well. So now I'm just gonna be very gentle before we get to the part where gravity will take over here. So I don't want to get too hard on the brakes and spin out. After all that work, I don't want the controlled descent to end in disaster. Disaster's waiting for this car in other ways. No, I'm not going to blow it up. I love my Sabre Turbo. Never blow it up. Not on purpose. But you know, it's doing all right as Commander's honking. Probably honking at Rocket because he's on a bicycle in front of him. But we're doing okay here. Not too bad at all. See how we do on this first bend. Went a little wide, but nothing dangerous. Come around to another sharp bend down here. Oh, hard on the brakes, hard on the brakes. As Rocket lands on top of my car. Did he just go flying off the side of the mountain? I believe he did. Way to go, Rocket. Looks like he's trying to pedal his way back up. That was pretty awesome the way he landed on my car, though. I dig that. So here we go for our first jump, and oh, very front heavy. Caused it to bounce off the wall and get a lot more speed than I'm really comfortable with, but got it back under control pretty damn quick. Oh, Rocket made his way back up and landed on my car again. Apparently, I'm now the new grinding rail for his bike. Ooh, that was not a pretty jump. But at least I managed to hold the slide to get around that corner. Didn't intend for that to happen, but it worked out all right. There we go. Well, I was about to say that jump was a lot prettier, but it wasn't because it caught the rock and then got hit by a rocket. Surprised he hasn't fallen off that bike as many times as he did the back of my car. Oh my god. Here we go. Big jump. Oh, ugly landing. And yeah, could not control the slide at all. Into a tree. So now we have to figure out how to get out of here in something that doesn't get the best grip in the snow. I think the answer might be to do a burnout and get it to slide around here. Yeah, Rocket, quit showing off on your mountain bike. There we go. Just going to power through it, see where we go. And apparently we're going to go that way, which is the wrong way. But, you know, the car kind of has a mind of its own at this point. Or physics has a mind of its own at this point. One of the two. Trying to get back over to the trail. But I think we'll make do with just getting down to this bit over here. If I can just avoid boulders, stumps, and trees, I think it'll be alright. Nope, back in came around. My character kind of looks pissed off at this point. I was too. Don't worry there, Beacon. I was pretty pissed off too. So, come on, just get me back over to the trail. That's all we've got to do. It's right here. There we go. We can avoid all those parts behind us and just carry on from here. Shouldn't be too bad from here on out. Oh, I think I have too much speed. Yep, brakes would not stop me. Well, how about we take a shortcut? Sounds good to me. Yeah, we'll take a shortcut. At this point, with this car, I'm willing to just let it have the shortcut. Because this has been frustrating. I mean, we're at 16 minutes so far on this car. Max sometimes is an entire Will It Off-Road video. And we haven't even gone back to the top yet. And you'll see how I got it back up to the top in just a minute. There was no way I was going to drive this thing back up. But we are down in 4 minutes 26 seconds. Which means going back to the top of Mount Chiliad via Cargo Bob. And now throwing it off the side to see how much damage it can take. Yeah, there was no way I was driving this thing back up, so I went and found a cargo bob and airlifted it. And we're off! It sounds like somebody is in the cargo bob, not sure who. Already a big crash with the rock. Lots of windows breaking. Ooh, now we're flipping end over end. Man, this car is getting some serious air. The sad thing is, pretty sure I already have the platinum on this Spinderella award, but I know if I didn't have, I would have seen it pop up several times on this series, the way these things go spinning through the air. All right, let's see if we can get under the wheels. There we go. Gonna have to back down through this part here a little bit, because I don't really have anywhere to turn around, except never mind, the rocks turned me around. Man, this car is taking me. Slamming into just everything possible. Oh, great. We're wedged against this rock. Even in the dry, muscle cars struggle here. So, I'm just going to do burnout, get the back end to come around and see if I can't wiggle my way off. There we go. That worked out well. Coming around to get stuck on another rock. Going to do the same thing. Just going to wiggle it around until I get loose. Even if it means going down backwards. Fine by me. I really don't know who's in the cargo bob. Probably Commander, most likely. think Rocket was still riding his bicycle at this point. It's not his bicycle. He stole it off some NPC. And then discovered that little glitch completely by accident. You guys have to let me know in the comments down below. Has that always happened on bikes? Where you do the hop and pedal once you've hopped? And it causes you to just kind of hover in midair? I don't know. You guys have to let me know. I tried it. It's a lot of fun. Oh my gosh, it is getting bounced all around in this muddy, bumpy bit. Not able to find traction anywhere at all. Which means I'm going to try to keep speed down because I really want to be done with this car. Love my Sabre Turbo, but it is not made for the snow. As we come up around the wood pile, we are down in 2 minutes, 17 seconds. Let's take a look at the damage. We've got all the lights gone, most of the windows. The hood and trunk is misaligned, and it has slightly bent wheels, and that's it. Hey, if you guys enjoyed this video, you know what to do. Hit that like button, get subscribed if you haven't already. Leave a comment down below. I'm Brendan72Mo, and I'll see you in the next video.